Starr's new supernatural costume drama Outlander is proving to be a massive success. It's broken the multi-platform viewing record for the Starz channel, and we would probably say it's in our top five series about time travel between the years 1945 and 1743. Starring Willoughby Katrina Balfe as a World War II nurse who's plunged back in time after an incident involving some magic rocks, and Sam Heughan as hot mess warrior in a kilt Jamie Fraser, Outlander is a smart, sexy, and above all, original take on sci-fi TV. We're already halfway through season one, so we're going to do a little catch-up to get you up to speed in time for the second half of the series. So it's 1945 and Claire and her husband Frank Randall have gone on a little holiday to Inverness to get to know each other again after 5 years spent apart during the war. Quite a few strange things happen to them, including Frank seeing a ghost and Claire having an unusual palm reading suggesting that her life will involve two marriages and will fork in some way. That night they decide to watch a pagan ritual at Craig Nadoon's stone circle in the countryside, and Claire returns the next day to look at some plants she'd spotted there, as she's a keen botanist. Suddenly, she's compelled to touch the main big rock and is plunged back in time to 1743 at the height of Scottish Civil War. She meets Frank's ancestor, who's an evil English redcoat, and he tries to rape her.
It's true that Captain Randall has a certain reputation.
You cannot undo the things you've done. It is not too late to win back your humanity.
But luckily, she's then rescued by a group of grubby men in kilts. She's taken to a castle run by the Mackenzie clan and kept under tight watch because they suspect her of being a British spy. The only positive in the situation is a rather dashing young man called Jamie Fraser, who's seeking refuge with the clan because he's been wrongly accused of a crime.
I taught you this game, lad. Now you're dead.
The most recent episode, episode 4, saw Claire trying to escape the castle in order to get back to the rocks at Craig Nadoon and travel back to the future. She works out an escape route, finds a horse, packs some food, and waits for a good time to sneak away. But then Galus, the village healer who's kind of taken Claire under her wing, begins to get suspicious and threatens to foil her plan. Anxious, Claire decides to make her escape during the Gathering, an event where the local men swear their allegiance to the castle laird, Colin Mackenzie. She persuades her watchers to leave her alone for a bit and also to drink her port concoction, which actually has a sedative in it, and then she makes her move.
Tonight would be my one and only chance to escape. Sometimes you find yourself on a path you never expected.
I need to leave this place.
What do you think you'd get, lass? On a dark night with a strange horse, with half the Mackenzie clan after you by morning.
She's stopped on the way out by Dougal, the castle laird's brother, who tries to rape her, so she knocks him out with a chair.
I'm leaving tomorrow and I'm taking you with me.
She runs out into the grounds and bumps into Jamie, who tells her that she doesn't stand a chance if she tries to escape, as there are extra guards around for the ceremony. He offers to escort her back to the festivities, but once they arrive, they're captured and forced into the hall where Jamie has to take his vow of allegiance.
Oh God, this is all my fault.
Now, this poses a problem that Claire wasn't aware of, because if he takes the vow, it will mean he'll probably succeed Colm as the laird of the castle, which will mean that Dougal will kill him as he wants the throne. But if he doesn't take the vow, then Colm will have him killed as he'll be deemed untrustworthy. Luckily, he gets away with swearing his alliance and kinship to the Mackenzies, but not vowing his allegiance, therefore managing to avoid the wrath of both Mackenzie brothers. I mean, he's just so charismatic. So the episode ends on quite a good note for him.
You wanted to send a message. This is what you get, and you fight back against the English.
The next day, Claire is taken on a wild boar hunt, and one of the men is fatally injured in an accident. She tends to him as he dies, which warms the heart of Dougal, who's her main sort of captor and enemy. But instead of this meaning that he doesn't suspect her anymore and will let her go, he actually asks her to go travelling around the Mackenzie land with him, as he says they'll need a healer. This is annoying for her at first, but then she realises that they might travel near to where the magic time travel rock is in Cregner Dune. So she goes with them, planning to escape no matter what.
I must get to the stones or die trying.
One way or the other, I will get the truth out of you.
I believe that you have secrets, Claire.
Dear God, please help me.
A very big question I have is, because the Reverend's wife who read Claire's palm specifically said that her life was going to be forked, does this mean that she's actually living out the present of 1945 still, or has she just completely disappeared? We got a glimpse of her husband searching for her in episode 2, but nothing else so far. Hopefully in the next few episodes we'll see what's happening in the present. In episode 4, there were times when 1940s music could be heard non-diegetically, hinting that the past and the future are kind of starting to interlink a bit, possibly. Any ideas, guys? Also, we're eager to see whether or not we can trust Galis. At first, she seemed trustworthy and almost wise to Claire's situation, but now she seems more suspicious and like she might actually be an antagonist in the story. Hopefully, we'll learn more in the next few episodes. FYI, episode 5 airs on Saturday, September the 6th. How are you finding Outlander? Do you have any theories about any of the topics that we've raised? We're hooked. Subscribe to the 86th Floor YouTube channel for more reviews, catch-ups and interviews. Hello YouTubers. This week, HBO's critically acclaimed detective horror series, True Detective, is being released on Blu-ray and DVD. We were avid fans throughout the series here at the 86th Floor, and many writers and critics said that it was one of the best series that's ever been shown on TV, and even had the potential to start a mini-series revolution in America.